Now we are on to a speaking section of test 1 IELTS 8. So the past one will be, the examiner is going to ask the candidate about himself or herself, his or her homework or studies and other familiar topics. And first of all, he is going to see your passport and match your photograph. And then he will ask about yourself. So you have to speak about yourself. Means, I am Mr. X, I belong to or I hail from, say Muzaffarabad, or and I live in Karachi, or you can say I belong to Agra and I am working at Delhi or Gurgaon. And about work or studies, I am in Accenture, I am a software analyst, or you can say I have completed my BSc nursing and I am a nurse at so and so hospital. And in familiar topics, you have to speak about the habits, your likings. Means, I prefer you can say swimming, and I like playing football, listening to music. So these are the answers you're going to give. And be precise, try to write your answer first, because this question is mandatory. This is going to be asked. This is a kind of pacification or pacifying period, where you know, when you have butterflies in your stomach and you reach for this speaking exam, then this question pacifies you, and there is a start of initiation of interaction between you and the examiner. Now we have the topic or the questions on neighbors. How well do you know the people who live next door to you? In this, you can very well say, because if in an Indian scenario, you can answer that I live in say Kriti Colony, which is situated near railway station of Dehradun, and this colony is a close colony, and we all know each other very well. And I know who lives or who are my neighbors. He is Mr. X, and this is on my right hand side. He is Mr. Y, and just in front of me, Mr. Z lives. And we are very good friends, and we generally invite one another in our events and occasions and festivals. Then, how often do you see them? Why or why not? This you can answer like this. If there are two opinions. If you are not able to see them, if you are living in an apartment, then you can say that in a week I usually meet them in person and talk to them. While on work, because I work from Monday to Friday, the shift is tight, so only sometimes they meet while I'm on stairs. So I generally say hello to them, and they also reply back. Generally we meet every once a week. And in the, if your opinion is like that, I meet every day, then you can say, because we live in a close society and the community, our houses are also, they share a common wall. Therefore, we generally meet every second day, and we discuss about various matters of the colony and ask about well-being of each other's family. Now, the question would be, what kinds of problem do people sometimes have with their neighbors? If you're asking about me, you can answer like this. If you're asking about me, I seldom have problems with my neighbors, but the problem sometimes which occurs is because of the pets we have. Like I have a dog, he barks, and my neighbor also has a dog, so sometimes they quarrel. And there is another problem is the parking, because we live next to each other, and sometimes my visitor comes. When they arrive, they are not aware where to park, so they park in front of my neighbor's house. So that may be sometimes a point of discussion. We never have that sort of problems between us, and we generally talk to each other and try to resolve the issues peacefully. Then how do you think neighbors can help each other? In this, you can answer that because I live in a very close community. Actually, this answer has also two opinions. First opinion is, I live in a close community, so my relatives, because I work in this place, my neighbors live in some other state or some other city. So whenever I have some problem, I want my neighbors, or I'm going outside, I request my neighbor to look after my house and to feed my dog. And sometimes I come late from the office, then I request them to switch on the light, front and rear light. And there's one more opinion that sometimes people live in apartment, or they are not very much into social life. They can say that we have friends in our office and we are living in a community. We have friends which are just 100 meters or 200 meters up, living far. So what generally happens is whenever we have some problem or any sort of requirement, then we generally call our friends or families if they are nearby. So this could be the answer. Then part two is, describe a time when you were asked to give your opinion in a questionnaire or survey. Then you should say what the questionnaire survey was about, why you were asked to give your opinions, what opinions you gave, and explain how you felt about giving your opinions in this questionnaire survey. So you'll have to talk continuous for 2 minutes, at least 2 minutes. And you have 1 minute to think about what you're going to say, and you can make some notes to help you if you wish. So let me take two different categories of people. One may be students and other may be working. So students may say that last week only I was asked, or a questionnaire was given to me, that how to improve the college and college canteen and the auditorium. So it was just about emancipating the level of the college premises and those who are coming to visit us, and those places where generally some event happened. So I have given my opinion that the auditorium has only a few seats, and those seats are not well maintained, and they can be changed. There is a possibility that we can have those chairs that are automatically folded. And for the canteen, I requested and I answered in a way that there are various food or drinks that can be added to the menu, and there are various people who generally go to fast or have different taste. For that, other food and drinks can be added for their liking, to their preference. And I'll take a next category, that is those people who are working, they are employed. They can say that last week or last month or yesterday only, I was asked the questions, or I was provided with a questionnaire about how to develop or how to increase the sales, and what may be the measures that the company can take to increase the sales, and also to how the company can reach and increase its outreach to various clients. In this, I answered in a way that we can have various programs or collaborative programs. We can call our clients, we can show or present our possibilities and our strengths, and also have a small get together like lunch or dinner. That will help create a bond between us, and this will make us or increase our reach to the clients. And also about sales, we have to see what the counterparts or our competitors are developing, and we have to be at par with the changing technology, and we have to add various components to our device or software so that the people or clients which are using it, or they are supposed to use it, will be quite happy to get extra bunch of functionalities. So this can be an answer for you. Two categories I have discussed. Now the part three will be discussion topics, like asking questions. For example, what kinds of organization want to find out about people's opinion? So in this, you can answer that there are various organizations which act as a survey organizations, which provide opinions, which provide questionnaires and surveys from, and they accept and they ask, maybe through web or personal questionnaire. They want to ask that what people need, what the client need, and these organizations, they making a consolidated data, after forming a consolidated data, they can give it or extend it to various organization or to the government or any company who has sought this information from them. Then do you think that questionnaires are or surveys are good ways of finding out people's opinion? In this you can answer, in my opinion, questionnaires and surveys are the best way of finding out people's opinion. Because once you extend the questionnaires to various people, then first is to choose a sample population, because you want to include all people of all ages, creed, caste, religion, and their beliefs. So you need to answer according to their needs. And once you present the questionnaire, then or you can say the surveys, and people will give their firm opinion and their open opinion about certain thing, which you cannot get with 4 or 5 people, or say 100 people sitting and discussing something. So it would be a best option, and I strongly recommend, and I strongly think the questionnaires or surveys are the best ways of knowing and including people in making of a company or a nation. Then the question may be, what reasons might people have for not wanting to give their opinions? In this, you can answer that the first reason I can think right now is that nobody wants to give their opinion if the confidentiality is not maintained. Means if his or her name will be put on internet or on the questionnaires, then he will be reluctant to answer. So that way, that is the first opinion. And second is, if something is not changing, the government is reluctant to take opinions, or the company management is not very much flexible, then there is no point in one wasting his or her time in going giving opinions. Now, one more is questionnaires in school. Example questions could be, do you think it would be a good idea for schools to ask students their opinions about lessons? In this, I have a very different opinion from those many people who would think that this is a good idea. What I think is that it will not be a good idea to ask schools or to allow schools to ask their students, because students are still students. They are they don't have so much experience. They are still growing, and they may not know what is good for them or what is not good for them. For these decisions, it would be good to give this responsibility to these people who know or who are very good at education, who know how to manage education and what to put in lessons. Then what would the advantages for schools be if they ask questions or students their opinion? In this, you can answer, sir, as I earlier indicated, that it will not be a good idea. But if you're asking the advantages of schools be if they ask students their opinion, advantages for schools, not for lessons, but for schools, then if, students, there are number of students, there are number of there are various classes, so different ages of students are present there. So somebody would not like the auditorium, somebody or someone would prefer games period more than mathematics, or somebody may not like a particular teacher or way the teacher teaches. So only from the students, the management or the schools may know what exactly their opinion are on the good or the bad thing, or any kind of suggestion which can make school better. Then we have, would there be any disadvantages in asking students' opinion? And this you can answer, there is always two opinions. One, whenever we have debate, there is one who is for and the other is against. So in this you can answer that disadvantages in asking student opinion. If students are still young, they don't know what is good for them and what is bad for them. But on the other hand, the advantages of students' opinion is the facilities, the teaching, and all other aspects which are related to schools. They are into it. They are undergoing it. So if they have some problem, this is always advisable that their opinions should be taken, so that the school and the aspects which are related to schools can be emancipated and can be made better. So this was speaking of test 1, IELTS 8. Thank you so much. Take care.